Just into CNN, we have the first images, the first photographs of the scene following this bombing here. Please take a moment here, because I do want to warn you, they're disturbing, as you might expect. So take that moment, and we're going to show some of them now. These some of the casualties, civilian casualties, it seems, taken away in wheelbarrows from the site of this attack, taken by eyewitnesses there. You can see the injuries. It also gives you a sense of where this attack took place. This is a corridor, in effect, leading into the airport. It is a very confined corridor, and those kinds of corridors, number one, they put people in a very confined space, makes for a very easy target for terrorists, but two, it could also accentuate the effects of explosives because it's in a confined space. That is something terrorists are aware of. It's something that terrorists take advantage of. Our Nick Robertson is with me now. Nick, you and I have covered our share of attacks like this one around the world. You and I were talking just yesterday about the danger and the level of concern among U.S. officials about an attack just like this one, and it has now happened. And there are Afghan casualties, as we can see in those pictures there, and CNN is reporting there are U.S. military casualties. It occurs to me as I look at those photos of the Afghans wounded in this attack, and to be clear, we now know that U.S. service members were also among the casualties in this attack. But when I look at those Afghans, Nick, I think of what they'll be left to after U.S. forces leave here. The Taliban running the country, the Taliban, a group that has carried out its own terror attacks, many dozens of them through the years, targeting both civilians and U.S. service members. Is this the future that Afghans have to look forward to?
It's not a pretty prospect in any way at all, Jim. I mean, if we just take the individual casualties on their way to some kind of medical treatment, the Taliban, we know that their leadership is going to lead to a downturn in the economy, and that means every facet of lives for Afghans, be it buying food, be it getting medical treatment in hospitals, where there'll be less material available to support them and help them and repair them in this case, that's all in the future. The potential for unpredictable attacks like this, this clearly remains. But I think the big thing on everyone's mind is, particularly for intellectuals, particularly for human rights activists, particularly for women, particularly for female journalists, particularly for anyone who doesn't hold to the Taliban's strict interpretation of Islam, is a real concern about their rule. We learned last night from a source that even senior figures, former politicians, Dr. Abdullah Abdullah, the former chief executive, the former president Hamid Karzai, who had until the past couple of days their own security detail and their own vehicles, are now essentially holed up in a house without their without transport and without any of their own security protection. Many vulnerable, many Afghans from top to bottom of society will be feeling exceptionally vulnerable.